for today I have something a little bit different, because this is the finals of the Greek Gods internal tournament, and I really like how these guys in Greek Gods are active, and organizing a tournament for guild members is really, really nice way, and it doesn't cost you a lot of time, so that's really great. They are focused on pre-made team battles, so even the tournament is for team battles. And there were six teams, and this is the finals. So the best two teams made it to the finals. And there were almost no rules, and the only one exception was that the call to arms was banned from the tournament, because it was before an update when it costs only 4 mana. But everything were allowed, wild cards were allowed, and they can change the decks between each games, because it was best of 3 and these finals are best of 5. And so here we have the blue team is Delta O and Klirovsky, and the red teams is Nataraya with Trickster, and these are actually top pre-made players, so I thought it might be interesting to show you the games, so you might see that Delta O with Klirovsky are playing Red Bow and Stormbringer, and so the Red Bow has quite a cheap cycle with double laser turret. Meanwhile, Nataraya and Trickster have Milloween with Arcane Golems and Morelia. So let's see the game. Fire Imp instantly fireballed, but at least he still was able to kill the Arcane Golem. And the blue team has quite an experienced lead because of the red bow with a lot of low cost cards, so he can hold the bridges for quite a long time. Yeah, this Soul Stealer can eat a lot of scrats, but he was dealt with Fireball. Why not? And you might remember a deck that I was showing with laser turrets, putting into this middle of the battlefield. It was really great, so this is something similar, but with only 2 laser turrets, I guess. And it's like holding the bridges for all the time. Yeah, so they started putting laser turret a little bit behind, so they have a place to put a unit for the arcane missiles, but still it was not enough, but at least they need a fireball and arcane missiles to deal with it. And now they are out of laser turrets, but yeah, there is one in the pocket, so I think that the red team will have a hard time dealing with these laser turrets because their tactic is just living statue and arcane golem, and like the red team can easily deal with it with laser turrets. Yeah, so something to stop the arcane missiles, but the fireball to kill the laser turret, but it was maybe not needed because there's no real push, so they can maybe let the laser turret to perish and save the fireball for the next one. Now they need to play another spell. Yeah, so the living statue almost dead. The blue team has really nice XP lead, so I think they are going for the mana frenzy. They have a lot of health. Meanwhile, the red team is behind with XP and with health, so and they actually can't do much because of these laser turrets. So let's see how this game will end. Maybe the dragon from Morelia can help a little bit. We will see, it will be quite soon. Yeah. Because they are third perk now. And like also the big arcane golems, they started as level 5. But the laser turret will be huge, I guess. And it looks like this is the last chance for the red team, because blue team now has mana frenzy, so unless they are making it now with dragon and arcane golem. Another arcane golem, so it looks really terrifying, but yeah, laser turret. Yeah, so GG. I also think that it's done, like the mana frenzy is here and the red team is far away from mana frenzy. And stacking the laser turrets here. Okay, so here's the second game. So as you might see, the blue team switched to APEP with Morelia, and red team is Ravager with Red Bow now. So as I said previously, they can or they could change the decks between each game as they wanted. So at least we will see completely different game. Yeah, so monkeys are here. Okay, so the Brutus push with Stormy. Will we see some healing for the Stormy? Probably not. And the Brutus is alone, so he can't do much. Yeah, Spirit Monster for the Skreds. Rock Rivals. Magma Storm for this. Wow. So, Magma Storm for no hits. Sometimes it's just bad luck with Magma Storm and it's like waste of 5 mana, but the next time it can save your life. So it's really randomness here. Wow. It looks like quite a big push with a few scrites. but that was actually that magma storm. Probably it was a waste of 5 mana, and it's really hard to catch up. So they took 2k damage and a little bit behind with XP, but not so much. Yeah, so another magma storm. Yeah, this time it was a little bit better. Now they have the shield totem, so it should help them to survive. Daggerfall too late for the Reboomer. And now the Rock Rival, so this is also quite late game deck for a red team because of the Rock Rivals. But the combustion is really, really great clear. So the blue team actually has two clears. It's magma storm and then combustion. So two ways how to deal with pushes. And the red team also. And combustion, so it will be difficult to push through these combustions. Another magma storm. Wow, this was perfect. Oh, Square Puff giving shields. And it looks like the blue team is controlling the bridges, but not too far ahead with XP. A little bit similar for both teams. I saw the Shen for the Terror Brutus, but Terror Brutus switched lanes. Living statue for the Stormy. Oh, and the combustion. Really, really nice clear. Oh, Spirit Monster on the plane for the Scrats. Yeah, but Magma Storm. Really nice. And except that one push in the beginning, like any team can't go through actually. So I think we are also going to the Mana Frenzy, and the blue team is a little bit ahead, and the dragon will maybe help them hold the bridges, or at least the top one. So combustion, scrats, poison strike is not so fast. So the dragon is gone. And now the blue team is holding the bridges for all the time. So now they have really an advantage with experience. Mana Frenzy coming soon. Storm for the Spirit Mancer. And the red team is surviving. It's a little bit easier to survive if you have this combustion, because you can clear the whole push, but in the end you will still lose the second wave, because then you are not cycled back for the combustion. So 2-0 lead for the red team. Blue team, sorry. So this is the third game. Delta OF Klirovsky, they have 2-0 lead, so it's a match point for them. And they chose again the red bow with Stormbringer. So it looks like the same decks as in the first game, with double laser turret and some cycle. And a trio with Trickster, they have Setsu and Ravager. So something new. Oh, Troubadour. I think Troubadour won't make it through because of these double laser turrets. So one laser turret is gone, but still second one ready. We are going for a big push. Also, even this second laser turret is dealt with spells and jump. So hypnotize. It was before an update, so it's still stealing the units. Or units are changing sides. Oh, so again, 2k damage with the first push. Looks like blue team has problems with with beginnings of the games. Again, they have an XP advantage. Living statue, Stunlancers and Shen dealing stunning all the time. And now the blue team is controlling the game, but the red team is maybe waiting for the Troubadour again. For now they have the Colossus. They jump for the laser turret to save the Colossus. But the second laser turret coming probably, and it was actually not needed. The Mordaka with all these crats were enough. Now the red team is also down to 1k health. And they really struggle. They are like, wow, one whole perk behind with XP. So let's see the second Troubadour push. But they will also need to deal with the statue, so they can't support the Troubadour match. The laser to that, second one. So that's it with Troubadour push. Yeah, and they are going for the race. hitting too late, so they are down to 200, and meanwhile on the other side it's decided